doing the same thing with clothes. Because target and who they followed, so it's good for you to look at your customer, your competition, and redefine your vision and mission, looking at your competition. Walmart looked at Target. You know, Target, you know, they, have you noticed, you know, now Target is bringing some fashionable clothes. Have you noticed that, they just, it's not so much of a blue color. They're bringing some fashionable. So Walmart's okay now, you know, because always Walmart had blue color. Now Walmart in their rearrangement and their changing their strategy planning is moving some of underwear, some of other stuff they had that used to be in the center of the store. Now they're moving it into the back and they're putting stuff like high-end and more fashionable clothes up front in direct competition with Target. Then, as I said, forecasting is essential preliminary to effective planning. Now, you are in management, most of you in engineering management program, and you have to understand that any engineer, even those that are not in management, have to be part of team to do forecasting, and forecasting and planning kind of go, as I said, hands to hand. If you do, if company do good forecasting, then they can do a good planning. See, and I think, you know, this strategy that Walmart has is a good one, because they're looking at the cap, they're forecasting, and that because of demise of some competition, they're gonna lure this customer into the store. And there is a lot of different type of forecasting companies. They do it for new facility, production planning, workforce scheduling. These are some of things that companies do to do forecasting, facility planning. They're changing their production, which of course in production planning and control. But there is so many aspects to forecasting. You want to look at long range forecasting. Companies have, you have to, not long-term forecast mainly goes to more high-tech companies in order for them to expand. Apple does a good job with iPod, you know, and some other new gadget. They always look at long-term. And in order to get the product out to the market, they have to make sure their forecasting is correct. And forecasting is not a science that is 100% accurate. No one have that crystal ball that you can sit down and say, okay, I can forecast, you know, that's it. And if they did, you know, we wouldn't be in this mess. We are in recession mainly because no one forecast. No one forecasted long term. You know, we came out of era during George Bush period, and nobody forecasted, you know, what's going to happen, you know. It's many times government borrows money, and they don't look at, they look at short term. They do short term forecasting. Because, you know, because of politics, sometimes government wanting, you know, just election is coming up, so they forecast that, oh, we need some vote. You know, so they don't look at long term. And in order to be successful, companies to be successful, you always need to look at long term forecast. And now, you know, we're coming out of recession. Again, government really need to do long term forecasting. What is it going to do with housing? There's some, they passed some packages and some stimulus packages as in the Congress. Mainly some of them was short-term, you know, this stimulus package and giving, I think, $8,000 to first-time buyer to buy a house. You know, to me, some of these are short-term. So, we have to wait and see if this is going to work or not, you know, because by November, this is going to end. So is this going to kick a start the economy or not? Right now, the unemployment even went up from last month. And forecasters are saying what? Right. Those expert forecasts are saying we're going to hit double digit. Now we have 9.7% national unemployment, and California over 12%. Last year was 7. So forecasting, as I said, if somebody forecasted last year, that it's going to be this much unemployment, you know, you would have planned accordingly. Like in, I taught a class in, I came here in January, I taught a class in 602 class, which is companies of future, how do you build the company, how do you, and I said like one thing was with oil forecasting. Oil came from 147 to 35, 36. And I remember I said, and I said to my class in 602, you know, it's documented. Next time I need to tape all the classes, you know, so all the, that stays there, so there is a record. Either good or bad, you know, nobody can get, nobody have the crystal ball. Sometimes I get some forecast right, and sometimes I don't get forecast right. But I forecasted that oil, and I called everybody I knew, including my brother. I said, you know, buy some oil contract. You need at least $50,000 to buy oil contract. And I forecasted for 2 years. You have to pay the forecasting. I forecasted that this year the oil is going to at least come up around the devil itself. Because it was ridiculous. When we went to 35 from 147, I mean, that was, it didn't take a genius to know that oil is going to come back up. And I still think longer term forecast for oil is going to be price going to be, because there is limited amount of oil in the world, and there is emerging technologies, emerging countries like China, India, that they're becoming more tech savvy, and because of labor shifting to these countries, they would need more oil, you know, for their economy to expand. So more demand create, you know, where there is more demand, create shortage of supply. It's a simple fact of forecasting, simple fact of supply and demand. So when it's more demand, it's going to be short supply, price is going to go higher. And we already see, you know, prices, just a few months ago, you could put gas in your car, I think it was $1.80 in California, now it's $3. So already, 40-50% added to price. So forecasting, as I said, is very critical to companies. And then you have short range forecast. Amount of inventory for next month, amount of product to produce next week, especially seasonal forecast. Again, Circuit City, very poor job in short-term forecasting. Christmas was coming up. They didn't look at, you know, that recession, people are not going to be buying some of these items. They ordered too many items. They were stuck, you know, with a lot of items they couldn't sell. So short-term and long-term forecasting is critical. And short-term, you know, sometimes could be brutal. If you miss, if you don't forecast, as I said, see, summer is coming, whatever period of, and if companies do a poor job in short-term forecasting, what's going to happen? You have two situations. Over inventory, you have under inventory. You either have too much of merchandise or you have too little of merchandise. And either case, company is going to suffer. What's going to happen if you have, especially, I don't know, have you ever tried to order something around Christmas time, around a store, and they are out of supply? All that comes back to poor, short forecasting for the company. What happens? If you want a product and you go to your favorite store and they're out of merchandise, what do? You go and you even pay, I've done the same thing, you know, okay? I needed, you know, I moved here right around Christmas time. And, you know, I just brought my basic stuff, so I had to buy everything else here. Because I mean, moved from Cincinnati, and it was a tough move and long move. So I wasn't planning, you know, to bring my bed and all the other stuff. You know, it was much cheaper for me to buy a new thing here than pay to move things from there to here. So then here, you know, I had limited amount of time on Christmas, and I wanted to buy some. And I went, you know, to a store, and they didn't have my, I had to wait 4 weeks. I had to wait for some furniture to come in 4 or 5 weeks. So I went, even though, and I paid more somewhere else that I could have the merchandise in my hand. So it's very critical for companies to do good short-term forecasting, especially when the season is changing. They have to anticipate the customers that are coming. So when you don't have the merchandise, customer turn to others. And you may lose the customer forever. You know, if you're unhappy, go and you have to wait, say, okay, God, you have that bad feeling about that company, you never go back to that company. Then with over-inventory, like Silicon City did,